Hello students, so far we have discussed two numerical methods to find the integral value when function is given in tabular form. What was? One is trapezoidal, another is Simpson one third. In Simpson one third rule, we have discussed earlier, if we have function like this, then we need 3 points to approximate a given function by interpolating these 3 points. Okay, but here in Simpson 3/8 rule, if we have given function like this in interval AB, function is continuous in closed interval AB. Okay, here also. So here we need one more extra point. Okay, that means we need 4 points, okay, to approximate the function. These are the 4 points. From this we can interpolate these points by function. Make sure these are the equidistance. Okay, these are the equidistance. Distance are same. So here interval AB is subdivided into 3 equal subintervals. Okay, so to derive the Simpson one-third rule, we have approximated function by quadratic polynomial. To derive the Simpson 3/8 rule, we approximate function by cubic polynomial. Okay, we have 3, 4 points, so we can generate a polynomial of order 3. Okay, hence we subdivide the given interval AB into 3 equal pairs so that we obtain these 4 points. Okay, and after that we can generate a cubic polynomial through interpolation. I mean, these are equal distance, so we can use the Newton interpolation formula for what difference. Okay, so let fx be continuous in closed interval AB. Okay, and what is h? H is b minus a by 3. Then these are all equidistant. Okay, so what is x naught? A is equal to x naught. This is x1, x2, this is x3. So x naught is equal to a, x1 is equal to a plus h, that means x naught plus h, x2 is equal to x naught plus 2h, x3 is equal to x naught plus 3h. Okay, is it clear? So using Newton forward difference formula, we have seen earlier in Simpson's one third rule. Okay, so using Newton forward difference interpolation formula, okay, the cubic polynomial approximation to fx interpolating at point where, suppose this is p, this is q, this is r, this is s. So interpolating point x naught fx naught, q x1 fx1, this is obvious, r x2 fx2, similarly s x3 fx3. Okay, so these are the points we have to interpolate using Newton forward difference formula. Is it clear? So what is the polynomial? In previous class we have seen how we find the polynomial if we have given points. So a function fx, here I will write directly fx naught plus x minus x naught divided by h delta fx naught plus x minus x naught x minus x1 divided by h square factorial 2 delta square fx naught, okay, plus, because we have 4 points, so this formula is up to cubic polynomial, okay, x minus x naught, x minus x1, x minus x2 divided by factorial 3 h cube delta cube fx naught. Is it clear? Since we have 4 points, then we can generate polynomial of degree. This is degree 3 polynomial. What is the integral value? We have already interpolated the given points, I mean 4 points, into a cubic polynomial. Now we have to use this polynomial into this function to integrate the given. We have used Newton forward difference formula to interpolate these 4 points, okay, and we have to find the area below this graph. I mean this is our fx, okay. We have already obtained by Newton interpolation formula, so we can use this function here. And what is the limit? Limit is nothing but x0 to x3. And what is the polynomial? Put it here, fx0 plus x minus x0 divided by h delta fx0 plus x minus x0, x minus x1 divided by factorial 2 h square delta square fx0, okay. And what is the next term? X minus x0, x minus x1, x minus x2 divided by factorial 3 h cube, and this is the delta cube fx0, okay. Now nothing here to do, simply obtain the integral value as we have seen earlier in Simpson 1/3 rule. So please find out. Here I will write directly what we will get is 3h divided by 8, and the functional value fx0 plus 3 fx1 plus 3 fx2 plus fx3, okay. We will find in general way in next step. For general term, let n is equal to 3n, okay. That means we have to divide given interval into multiple of 3 subintervals, okay. So multiple of 3, this is the interval AB, and we have to divide it in 3n. What is 3n? N belongs to set of natural number, we can say, and 3n number of subinterval, number of subinterval, okay. This is important. 3 by 8 rule, then we have to divide the given interval into 3n number of subinterval, okay. What was in Simpson 1 by 3rd rule? We have to divide the given interval into even number, I mean 2n type, okay. So very simple. So what is the integral value? A to b fx dx, which is nothing but this is the x naught, this is the xn, okay. So integral value is nothing but the sum of this we have these 4 points, so we can generate, first find this integral value plus this one, and we can go further, okay. So this is the x naught to xn fx dx. Here also I will write directly. So students, how we will remember this formula? This is the first term, this is the last term, and this is the term multiplied with 2, which is multiple of 3, and rest term are here multiplied by 3, okay. So from this way we can remember this formula. This is the Simpson 8-3-8 rule, okay, 3-8 formula, okay. So student, I have one question for you. Integrate 0 to 1 function is 1 by 1 plus f square by using Simpson 3-8 rule. Okay. So one thing to keep in mind is if we have to use Simpson 3 by 8 rule, then divide the given interval into 3n number of subinterval. Okay. This thing you have to keep in mind. So our interval is 0, 1. Okay. And function is 1 by 1 plus x square. Okay. So here we have to divide the given interval 0, 1 into 3n number of subintervals. So here I choose 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Okay. This is x0, x1, x2, x3, x4, x5, and this is x6, which is equal to 1, which is equal to 0. And here I choose n is equal to 6. So what is our h? H is equal to nothing but 1 minus 0 divided by 6. Okay. N is 6 means this is multiple of 3. Okay. So we can choose. So what is the functional value at given this x1, x2 and so on. So what is the x1? 1 by 6. This is 2 by 6. This is 3 by 6, 4 by 6, 5 by 6. This is equal to 1. Is it okay? So here we will find the functional value first. So what is the value? X0, x1, x2, x3, x4, x5 and x6. This is 0, 1 by 6, 2 by 6, 3 by 6, 4 by 6, 5 by 6 and finally 1. So this is our x. Okay. Now we have to find the value of function. What is the function? This is 1. This is 36 divided by 37. 36 divided by 40. 36 divided by 45. 36 divided by 52. 36 divided by 61. 1 by 2. Okay. So these are the functional value at given equidistance point from x0 to x6. So what was the formula of Simpson? 1 by third rule, 0 to 1 dx 1 plus x square is equal to 3h divided by 8 fx0 plus fx first and last plus 3 fx1 plus fx2 plus fx4 plus fx5 plus 2 into multiple of 3, that means fx3. Okay, so this is the formula because our h is 1 by 6. Okay, so 1 plus 1 by 2. Here only put the value of function which we have find earlier. Okay, this one we have to put it here all the value. That's 2 into 36 divided by 45. So this is the value. Finally we will get 0.78 53958. Okay, this is the value we have obtained from Simpson 3 by 8 rule. Now what is exact? Exact solution 0 to 1 dx 1 plus x square, which is equal to tan inverse x 0 to 1, which is equal to pi by 4, and pi by 4 is equal to 0.78 53982. Okay, so there is some error. So how we reduce the error? We have to divide the given interval into more number of sub intervals. Here we choose only 6. You can check from when n is equal to 12, 15, etc. Okay, So please, I have one question. Please solve it for n is equal to 9 and n is equal to 12 and compare the results. Okay. So that's all for today. Thank you.